Hello student, welcome back to part 2 video of your chapter cubic statement. Let's begin with circle statement. Now circle statement is used to draw a circle, ellipse is an oval shape, or you can even calculate the area of a circle. So basically, what are the parameters required for a circle statement? Syntax is circle, you have to write circle, and in bracket you have to give x and y value and r and p. The coordinates of x and y specify the center location of a circle, that is the which part of the screen. Suppose you want to draw a circle at this segment, or you want to draw in the extreme right corner, and so on. So this you have to do at the xy coordinate. Then that this will show you the, or you give the location of the circle on the screen. R gives the value of the radius, because circle is drawn only when you get the radius, and then P specifies the color code. Okay, so screen 7, first set the resolution to 7 so that you can have the use of all 16 colors. Then color 14.5 will change the foreground to 14 and 5 as a background color. Now you can print, this is the circle, so this will message will be shown here. And circle 160, 100, this is xy coordinate, and then 70 is the radius, that is radius is from center to the edge, whatever is the size, that is the radius. And 15 is the color of the your graphic, okay, that is orange color coming, okay, and then end it. So this way you can create a circle. Okay, now there are some more examples. You can see here 3-2 circles it has been drawn, 50, 50, 80, 50, 20, 10, and so on. Okay, so this way you can see 4 circles has been created. So for 4 circle you have to give 4 times circle statement. So whatever number of circle you want to draw, you have to give that as many, that number time of circle statement. Then we have paint statement. Now paint statement is used to fill any closed shape with a color. Closed mean it should be closed from all the side. This is the closed shape. Okay, no break should be there. So just to fill that, we have paint statement. The general format of paint statement is paint, xy color and border color. Xy denotes the coordinates from where painting should start, and their coordinates should lie within the closed area that has to be filled. Okay, now CLS is there, screen 13, so it will set the resolution 13. In circle 150, 50, 40, 2, and the same coordinate you have to give for paint, because I want to we have to color the same circle. So same coordinates will go, and 13, 2, that is 13 is the color of the circle and 2 is the color of the border. Okay, so this way you can use paint statement. Then we have control statement. Now what is the use of control statement? To control the flow of a program according to your choice, control statements are meant to control the flow of the programming. QBasic has many control statements. Normally what happens, when we write the set of instruction, your program will execute one after the other. Okay, and one after the other instruction will be executed. But with the help of control statement, we can, based on some condition, we can ask the QBasic to execute a particular statement or not. Okay, according to the condition only, the flow of your program, the flow of control will be restricted. Okay, now one we have if then statement. Basically sometimes we need if then statement for decision making statement. If then statement tests a particular condition for taking any decision. For example, if I am giving you two state numbers A and B, suppose A I have written 5 and B I have written 6, and I say that A is greater than B, so you will be answering either true or false. So right now it is false, because A is not greater than B, and I want to print the highest number. So if A is greater than B, then A's value will not be printed. Okay, so based on this condition only we are executing our set of statement. Clear? Now how the we are going to use, you have to write, this is the syntax. If you have to write, then in angular bracket there is the condition, and then and in angular bracket statement is there. Okay, now next is if the condition is true, the instruction specified after then means this statement will be executed, and if it is false, the control shift to the end, that means this statement will not be executed and the control will shift to the end, ignoring everything which is written after then statement. You can see input name dollar sign is there. As I told you that to get the name or store the name value in any variable, you need to write dollar sign at the end. If name dollar is equals to Jatin and inverted commas, we have to write the string type of data. Then print hello Jatin. Okay. Now you can see input name dollar is there. Then if name dollar is equals to Jatin, then print hello Jatin. Suppose user has entered John. So John will be the value of name dollar. Okay. Now is John is equal to Jatin? No. So it will not print hello Jatin. Okay. It will print hello Jatin only if the user will enter Jatin for name dollar. Okay. So this is how you will use. Now if the condition is true, then what will happen? Then only this will be printed. And what if the condition is false? If the condition is false, then we will be using else statement. So whatever is written after else, that will be executed. You can see here if then else statement. If then else statement are used for taking decision and also for making comparison. If it is true, the computer follows the statement given after the word then, and if not so, the computer ignores the statement after the word then and move to the else part. Now one has been added, else. So else will execute it only if the condition is false, and this else part to execute the statement stated there. Okay. Now if condition, you can see same format is there, only extra else has been used. So if this is true, so this then statement will be executed, and if it is false, so this will not execute and else statement will be executed. So this will make your program much better, because we have the output for true statement also and we have the output for false segment also. So now here you can see to print the series with a gap of 4 between 1 and 50. So n is equal to 1 we have to send. If n is less than 51, then go to else, go to here, you have to write 40, 30, here you have to write 30, the line number, else go to 60, so it will go to 60, otherwise it will go to 60, okay, go to statement is used to jump your control of your program. So here line number they have not mentioned, here you are supposed to get 30. 30, these are line number 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. Basically, in QBasic, we need to give the line numbers. 10 we have written, n is equals to 1. So the value of n is set to 1. Now it will check. If n is less than 51, so it will go to 30. And what is written on go to 30? You have to print the value of n. And the value of n will be changed by 4. That is the value to the value of n, 4 will be added. Okay. And then again it will come to line number 50. What is written? Go to 20. Now again it will go back to 20, and again the statement will be checked. It is still now the new value of n will become 5. Okay, n is equals to 5. Now what will happen after coming here, when the value of n will become 5, you can see here, because 1 to 1 if 4 is added, it will become 5. I will again check. If n is less than 51, then what will happen? It will go to 30. And what is written on 30? It is written print n. So what it will print? First time it has printed 1, and then it will print what? It will print 5. Okay. Now n is equal to n plus 4. So what is the value of 5, n? 5 it is. And 5 to 5, 4 is added. So it will become 9. So the new value of n will be 9. So what it will do, again it will go to, it will come to new line number, and then 50 line number, it will go back to again 20. So this will continue till the value of n is less than 51. As soon as the value of n will become 51, okay, then what will happen? This will become false. And which statement will be executed? This will not execute, this will not execute, and else block will be executed. And what is written here? Go to 60. So it will come here, and then again you can see here it is written else go to 80. Now 80, what is written? N. So this way your program will be ended, and you will see the gap of 4, 1, 4, 1, sorry, 5, then what will be printed? 9, then 13, and so on. Okay, this will print till the value of n is less than 51. Okay, and one more thing, if you have written f, after writing all the statement, you have to end if also by using end if statement. So end if statement is written without any other thing, it is written as it is. Okay, so this is the program of if else. Same way you can see here it is written, please enter your marks in mass. When math is written, a variable, then if math is greater than 85, then it will print good score in math. Else, if it is not greater than 85, what it will print? Keep working. And end if, your program end if is closed, and then end. Okay, so this way what will happen if the marks user has entered 54, so it will not do, it will just write keep working is displayed. If marks is 86, then what it will do? Good mark in mass is displayed. Okay, now here you have to give only 1. Okay, this you don't have to give. So you can see the output. Okay, next is counters. Now counter is used basically, sometimes we need to repeat a set of statement or a particular statement for a known number of time. Okay, so in that case we have looping statement. Now looping statement means repeated execution of a statement or a set of standard. The advantage of using looping technique in programming is that it reduces the number of instruction and also the memory space required. Okay, so this will looping statement we will continue in our next video. So till then, revise if else and if part properly, try to write the program, practice it, and try to write also without seeing the examples. Okay, so thank you children.